Hey, I thought I'd do a quick video on how I use my LG CX TV as a PC monitor, because I've seen people say that you can't use it as a PC monitor, but it's absolutely doable. And in fact, I've been doing it for about 6 months now, and I'm absolutely loving it. It's an incredibly good display, and it's very doable, but there are a few settings I recommend. First of all, I recommend that you have at least 80 centimeters desk to put the TV on. The foot of the TV extrudes about 15 centimeters behind, so you can't put it all the way back to the wall. But of course you could wall mount it, so at least 80 centimeters desk, or maybe a 90 centimeters would be better. But I have an 80 centimeters desk, and it's very doable for me. Another thing, this is the first display I've owned that I always run HDR in Windows with HDR on. Because HDR in an OLED just looks amazing, and it's finally getting good support in Windows 10. So, but first I want to talk about burn-in, because a lot of people worry about burn-in with OLEDs. So you can do a few things to prevent burn-in. First of all, you can remove the desktop icons on the desktop. So I usually do that. So I'll remove these desktop icons. Another thing you can do is hide the taskbar. And you shouldn't run a static image like this for a long time. So what I use is a program on Steam that's called Wallpaper Engine, which allows you to run animated desktops. But one of the best ways to prevent burn-in is to use the built-in burn-in prevention features of the TV, and don't run the TV with a brightness or OLED light all the way to 100. If you hold the settings button, and here in OLED screen saver, Pixel Refresher, I run that once a month. It runs when you turn the TV off, and it takes about an hour, so it's good to do it when you're going to sleep. Screen Shift will shift the screen 1 or 2 pixels to the side or up or down. And Local Luminance Adjustments I have set to low, but it detects logos and HUDs that are constant and will dim them automatically. But of course, the best feature is just to turn the TV off if you're not using it, or put it to sleep. I always do it if I'm gonna walk away for a few minutes. Then I disable, or no, then I sleep the TV. Like I said, I always run HDR on. If you go to Windows HD color settings and switch to the desktop, you can select use HDR and use this slider to tell Windows how to map SDR content in HDR space. I like it in the middle, so I can show you the effect this does. I have two videos here. The one on the left is an SDR video, and the one on the right is an HDR video. So if I play them both, and move the slider, it only affects the brightness on the left image. So I'll quickly run over the settings I have for the TV. Again, if you hold this, let's begin with the most important setting. If you hold in the input key, that's this one, you'll be taken to the dashboard. And it's important to tell the TV. If you go to settings, edit, so tell the TV that the input you have connected to PC, that it's a PC. So you click the icon in front of it and select PC. That puts the TV in PC mode for that input, and it will disable some built-in processing of the TV to lower input latency. Get the fastest response. And if you hold in the settings key in this one, I have energy savings off because that will dim the screen based on content. I don't like that. additional settings. Eye comfort mode is a blue light filter. If you get fatigue, you can turn this on. HDMI ultra deep color, you need that for HDR, so make sure that's on for the input your PC is connected to. Instant game response, it should turn on automatically, but make sure it does. And AMD FreeSync, I recommend putting that off because that disables Dolby Vision. Filmmaker mode, I keep that on, but I haven't found any sources that contain Filmmaker metadata. But in theory, it will automatically switch to it if you play content with Filmmaker metadata. For the picture mode, I run it in HDR game mode. And when I'm using it for day-to-day work, I keep OLED from or maybe 20 to 40. But when I'm gaming, especially an HDR game, I put it to 80 to 100. If you get eye fatigue, you can lower this to maybe 10 or something. It's still bright enough to work on. I have contrast set to 100, brightness to 50, sharpness to 0, color to 50, and tint to 0. Under advanced control, I recommend putting dynamic tone mapping to HDIG, because if you have dynamic tone mapping on and then try to adjust the game's luminance, then it doesn't really make sense because the TV will be keep analyzing the image and changing the dynamic tone mapping, while HDIG puts it on the source or the PC or the game to set the tone mapping. White balance, if I remember correctly, the color temperature out of the box is medium, which is too blue for me. So I really like the warm 2 preset, so I recommend that. Let's go back. And the reason these things are grayed out is because I have set it to PC mode. Picture options, there's not much here. Motion eye care, again, if you have eye fatigue, you can turn it on. I don't like it, so I have it off. Black level, I have it set to auto. And I think that's about it. Of course, it's always good to check if the TV has a new firmware. So just to do that, go to support, firmware, software update, and check for update. I have no update. Another thing I found helpful is the clear text. The built-in clear text tuner for Windows 10. If you load that. It actually says it's off, but it's in fact on because I have another program that tunes the clear text, because the OLED do not have RGB, they have WRGB pixel layout, and Windows clear type text tuner doesn't take that into consideration. So if you open up something with text here, let's go to Windows. I'm not sure if the camera can show this, but you should try this out. If I run the clear text tuner, you have to run it as an admin. Let's go back to Windows. So now the font looks good to me, because I have selected the grayscale mode, which is not available with the built-in tuner. But if I select RGB, then the text doesn't look as good to me. I can see some fringing on the text. BGR, it's some VA panels, or most VA panels, I believe, use BGR. It's even worse than RGB, but grayscale looks really good to me. And you can also turn it off. But then the text looks way too sharp, so I leave it like this, and this is how I like it. Maybe the last thing I want to go over is settings in the NVIDIA control panel. So if you open control panel, First of all, make sure you're running in 120 Hz, because out of the box it will not enable 120 Hz. It will go to this Ultra HD 4K native resolution, which is capped at 60 Hz. But if you scroll down to PC settings, you can select 4K and 120 Hz, and make sure you're running 10-bit color, RGB, and full dynamic range. One other setting I recommend, although going over these settings is maybe out of the scope of this video, but make sure you have preferred refresh rate set to highest available. Sorry. So I think that's about it for this video. If you have any suggestions or other settings you recommend for OLEDs, for using OLEDs as a PC monitor, please comment, and don't forget to subscribe and like. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.